ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக. வெல்கம் டு ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சீ த டாபிக் நம்பர்ஸ் இன் திஸ் எக்ஸசைஸ் 1.3. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன், வெரிஃபை த க்ளோஷர் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஃபார் அடிஷன் அண்ட் மல்டிப்ளிகேஷன் ஃபார் த ரேஷனல் நம்பர் -5/7 அண்ட் 8/9. ஸோ கிவன் ரேஷனல் நம்பர் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு வெரிஃபை த க்ளோஷர் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஆஃப் அடிஷன் அண்ட் மல்டிப்ளிகேஷன். First, let's see what is the closure property of addition. For any two rational numbers a and b, the sum a plus b is also a rational number. Here they are given -5/7 and 8/9. So a is -5/7, b is 8/9. The sum of two rational numbers is also a rational number. So you add and check whether you are getting rational number or not. So that is the closure property for addition. A plus b, so a is -5/7 plus b is 8/9. So here the denominators are different, so we cannot add directly. So what do you want to do here? We want to take LCM. So 7 and 9, find LCM. So 7 table one time, then 9, it's not multiples of 7, so write down as it is. Then 3 table, 1s are, 3 3s are 9. Again 3 table, 1, 1. So the LCM is 7 into 3 into 3. So LCM is 63. So here we have the denominator is 7. If you want to change the LCM as 63, means by which number you want to multiply? 7 9s are 63. Here 9 is there. So here also we want to take the LCM as 63. So we want to change the denominator as 63. So multiply by 7. So -5 into 9 is -45 by 7 9s are 63 plus 8 7s are 56 by 63. Now the denominators are same. So what do you want to do here? We want to simplify only the numerator. So -45 plus 56 by 63. So -45 plus 56 is 11 by 63. So what is the biggest number? 56 is the biggest number. So positive will come. So whether 11 by 63 is a rational number? Yes, 11 by 63 is a rational number. So we prove closure property for addition. So the closure property for addition is, for any two rational number a and b, then the sum also it's a rational number. So we got the 11 by 63. So 11 by 63 is the rational number. So closure property is verified. So therefore closure property is verified. Next one, same number, you are going to check whether closure property for multiplication. What is the closure property for multiplication? Same, for any two rational number take, then the product is also a rational number. So here it is given a is equal, let's take a is equal to -5/7, then b is equal to 8/9. So the product is the meaning is multiplication. So a into b, check whether you are getting rational number or not. So -5/7 multiply 8/9. So if it is possible to cancel, means cancel. So 5/7 we can't able to cancel. 8/9 also it's a different number. In crafts way also we can't able to cancel. So directly you can multiply. -5 into 8, my 5 8s are 40 by 7 9s are 63. So -40 by 63 is also a rational number. So the product is also a rational number. Therefore closure property for multiplication verified. So you have to check whether the product is a rational number or not. That is the closure property for multiplication. Second question, verify the commutative property for addition and multiplication for the rational number minus 10 by 11 and minus 8 by 33. So first we need to know what is the commutative property for addition. So the commutative property for addition is a plus b is equal to b plus a. That means if order is interchanged also, the answer will not change. So let's take a is equal to minus 10 by 11 and b is equal to minus 8 by 33. So first we will prove here left hand side. So LHS is equal to a plus b. A value is, instead of a value you can substitute minus 10 by 11 plus b value is negative. So use bracket minus 8 by 33. So next step, remove the bracket minus 8 by 11 minus plus into minus is minus 8 by 33. Here the denominators are different. So take LCM, 11, 33 LCM. So 11 table, 1s are, 3 11s are 33. Then 3 table, 1, 1. So the LCM is 11 into 3 is 33. So here we have the denominator is 11. We need to change the denominator as 33. So by which number you want to multiply here? By multiplying 3. Here already we have denominator is 33. So no need to multiply any number. So minus 10 into 3 is minus 30. By 11 into 3 is 33. Minus 8 by 33. So both negative means you want to add, then put negative sign. So minus 38 by 33. So this is a LHS answer. Then let's find out RHS. RHS, it's equal to B plus A. So check whether you are getting same answer. So B is minus 8 by 33 plus A value is minus 10 by 11. So use bracket minus 10 by 11. Next step, remove the bracket minus 8 by 33 plus into minus is minus 10 by 11. So the LCM is 33 and 11 is 33. So already we have 33, but here 11 is there. So that alone will change. So by which number you want to multiply? By 3. So minus 8 by 33 minus 30 by 33. So here also both negative. So add minus 8 minus 30 is minus 38 by 33. So let's check the answer left hand side and right hand side. So we got the same number, minus 38 by 33. So LHS equal to RHS. Hence verified. So commutative property of addition is a plus b is equal to b plus a. So if order is interchanged also, the value will not change. So let's take a is minus 10 by 11 and b is minus 8 by 3. So first you will verify left hand side a plus b and verify. Then same like RHS also you will verify. Then check whether both the answer, if it is equal, means so LHS equal to RHS. Hence the commutative property of addition is satisfied. So hence verified. Same commutative property for multiplication. So same commutative property of multiplication is same A into B is equal to B into A. If there is no sign in between the variable, means it belongs to multiply. So same question. Let's take A is equal to minus 10 by 11 and B is equal to minus 8 by 33. Same like you can verify left hand side. LHS is equal to AB. So A is minus 10 by 11 multiply B is minus 8 by 33. So if possible to cancel, mean cancel. So we can't able to here cancel. So multiply minus into minus plus. 10 into 8 is, it's 80. 11 into 33 multiply. 11 into 33. 3 ones are 3, again 3 ones are 3, then multiply 3 ones are 3, then 3. So add 3, 6, 3, 363 by 363. So this is your LHS answer. Then find out RHS. RHS is the meaning is, it's your right hand side. So B into A. If order is interchanged, means whether you are getting same answer or not, you will check B into A. B values minus 8 by 33, multiply, then A values minus 10 by 11. So here also we can't able to cancel. So multiply, minus into minus plus, 8 into 10 is, it's 80, by 33 into 11 is 363. Already we multiplied. So check, LHS is minus 80, LHS is 80 by 363, RHS also 80 by 363. So both the answers are correct. So LHS is equal to RHS, hence commutative property of multiplication is we are satisfied, so hence verified. Third question, verify the associative property for addition and multiplication for the rational number minus 7 by 9, 5 by 6 and minus 4 by 3. Here you want to check associative property for addition. So given number you can check, take A, B and C. Then you have to check whether it is both the side, it's equal or not. So associative property of its addition is A plus, open the bracket, B plus C. Then close the bracket, it's equal to A plus B plus C. So just a bracket alone it is interchanged. Then you have to check whether both the side you are getting same answer. So let's take A is equal to minus 7 by 9, B is equal to 5 by 6, C is equal to minus 4 by 3. So what is your left hand side? LHS is equal to A plus B plus C. So A is minus 7 by 9 plus B value is 5 by 6 plus C value is negative, so use the bracket, minus 4 by 3, minus 7 by 9, plus 5 by 6, remove the bracket, plus into minus is minus 4 by 3. So take LCM because the denominators are different. So 6 and 3 LCM is 6. So here you want to multiply with 2. So bracket value first you can simplify, minus 7 by 9 plus 5 by 6 minus 4 2s are 8 by 6. So minus 7 by 9 plus 5 minus 8 is minus 3 by 6. So next step, remove the bracket, minus 7 by 9 plus into minus is minus 3 by 6. So 9 and 6 LCM is, find out 9 and 6 LCM, 3 table, 3 3s are 9, 2 3s are 6. Again 3 table, 1 time, then 2. Then 2 table, 1 1. So the LCM is 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18. So the LCM is answer is 18. Here which number you want to multiply here? By 2, here 3. So you will get minus 14 by 18, minus 9 by 18. So 2 negatives. So add minus 23 by 18. So this is your LHS answer. Then check your RHS side, whether you are getting minus 23 by 18. So RHS is A plus B plus C. So substitute instead of A, B and C value, minus 7 by 9 plus 5 by 6 plus minus 4 by 3. So if negative means use bracket. For 9 and 6 LCM is, either you can take 9 and 6 LCM or together you can take LCM. So 9 and 6 is LCM is, it's 18. So LCM is equal to 18. So here multiply by 2, multiply by 3. Then here, by which number if you are multiplying, you will get 18. 3, 6 are 18. So together you can take the LCM. Minus 14 by 18 plus 15 by 18 plus into minus is minus. 4, 6 are, it's minus 24 by 18. So minus 14 plus 15. 1 by 18 minus 24 by 18. So 1 positive and negative means you want to subtract. 1 minus 24 is 23. Biggest number is minus 24. So put negative sign. Minus 23 by 18. So what is your LHS answer? LHS also it's minus 23 by 18. RHS also minus 23 by 18. So both the side we got same number. So LHS is equal to RHS. Hence verified. So here they are given. Associative property of addition is 3 rational number it is given. So in this property you can substitute instead of A, B and C. Then check whether left hand side, right hand side, whether you are getting same number, same rational number. Once if you are getting same answer means the associative property for addition is verified. Let's see. So another property is associative property of multiplication. So same A into B bracket B into sign to B bracket into C. If there is no sign in between means you can consider that as multiplication. Same A is equal to minus 7 by 9, B is equal to 5 by 6, C is equal to minus 4 by 3. So let's take LHS. LHS is equal to A into B into C. A is minus 7 by 9, B is 5 by 6, multiply minus 4 by 3. Here, we can cancel 2 table, 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6. Then minus 7 by 9, multiply 5 2's are 10, minus 10 by 3 3's are 9. So minus into minus plus, 7 into 10 is 70 by 9 9's are 81. So this is our LHS answer. Let's check RHS. RHS is equal to AB bracket into C. So A value is minus 7 by 9 into B value is 5 by 6. Then multiply C value is minus 4 by 3. So here we can't able to cancel. So directly you can multiply minus 7 5's are 35 by 9 6 are 54. Then multiply minus 4 by 3. So here we can cancel 2 table. 2 2's are 4. Here 2 2's are 4. 7 2's are 14. So minus 30, minus into minus plus 35 into 2 is 70. 27 into 3 is 7 3's are 21. 1 2 is balance. 3 2's are 6. 6 plus 2 is 81. So LHS also 70 by 81. RHS also 70 by 81. So both it is equal. So LHS equal to RHS. Hence associative property for multiplication is verified. So hence verified. So verify distributive property. Next question is verify distributive property of A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. For the rational numbers are given, A is minus 1 by 2, B is 2 by 3 and C is minus 5 by 6. So let's take left hand side LHS A into B plus C. So A value is minus 1 by 2 into B value is 2 by 3 plus it's negative, so use bracket minus 5 by 6. Remove the bracket minus 1 by 2 into 2 by 3 plus into minus is minus 5 by 6. So the LCM of 3 and 6 is 6. So here only you want to multiply with 2. So because we want to change the denominator as 6. So 2 2's are 4, 3 2's are 6. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, 4 by 6 minus 5 by 6. So 4 by 6 is positive, minus 5 by 6 is negative. So on positive, negative means you want to subtract minus 1 by 2, then minus 1 by 6. So bracket is the meaning is multiply minus 1 by 2 into minus 1 by 6. So minus and minus plus 1 by 12. So our LHS answer is 1 by 12. So let's check RHS. A into B plus A into C. So A value is minus 1 by 2 and B is 2 by 3 plus A is minus 1 by 2, C is minus 5 by 6. So here 2, 2 we can cancel. So minus 1 by 3 plus minus and minus plus 5 by 12. 2, 6 are 12. So the LCM is 12. So here we want to multiply by 4. So minus 4 by 12 plus 5 by 12. So on positive or negative means we want to subtract. So 1 by 12. So RHS answer also it's 1 by 12. So both the answer is correct. So distributive property is verified. So LHS is equal to RHS ends verified. Let's see the next question. Verify the identity property for addition and multiplication for the rational number. Here they are given two rational number. So verify the identity property for addition and multiplication. What is the identity property for addition? Identity property for addition, that means any rational number, if you are adding with 0, means what you will get, children? Same rational number only you will get. So 0 plus a is equal to a, then 0 plus a. So any rational number, if you are add with 0, means you will get the answer is same rational number. Here they are given 15 by 19. So let's take a is equal to 15 by 19. And check whether you are getting same rational number. So my 15 by 19 plus 0. It's equal to 15 by 19. So we are getting same only. So 0 is the additive identity for 15 by 19. Hence 0 is the additive identity for 15 by 19. So we are getting same rational number. So this 0 is the special value. So we can call it as 0 is the additive identity for 15 by 19. Then same check multiplicative identity. So any number multiply with 1, what you will get, children? Same rational number. So additive identity property for multiplication. So 1 into a is equal to a is equal to a into 1. So any rational number multiply with 1 means you will get the same rational number. So here they are given a is equal to minus 18 by 25. So multiply and check whether you are getting same rational number. So minus 18 by 25 into 1 minus 18 by 25. So 1, this 1 is called the multiplicative identity. So therefore hence 1 is the multiplicative identity for minus 18 by 25. So yes, 0 is the additive identity and 1 is the multiplicative identity. Why 0 is called additive identity? Any rational number, if you are add with 0, you will get same rational number. That's why 0 is called the additive identity. and any rational number multiply with 1, you will get the same rational number. So this 1 is called the multiplicative identity. Next question, verify the additive and multiplicative inverse for rational number minus 7 by 17 and 17 by 27. First thing you need to know, additive inverse of additive inverse property. So here they are given minus 7 by 17. So let's take A is equal to minus 7 by 17. Then additive inverse property is A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A is equal to 0. That means that opposite sign, if positive, if you are adding with negative means you will get the 0, or negative if you are adding with positive you will get the 0. Same rational number, if it is sign is different means you will get the 0. So here A is minus 7 by 17. So what is the value of minus A? So minus A is minus of this rational number. So minus into minus plus. So 7 by 17. So let's substitute and check. A plus minus A value. A is minus 7 by 17. And B is, and that means minus A is 7 by 17. So same rational number, positive and negative means it's 0. So this is here. A plus minus A value is 0. Then if order is interchanged, minus A plus A. So 7 by 17 minus 7 by 17. It's equal to, again, same rational number, positive and negative means the answer is 0. So A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A is equal to 0. So additive inverse is, it's true for the given rational number. Therefore, A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A equal to 0 is true. Then multiplicative inverse property is, multiplicative inverse property is B into 1 by B. Same order is interchanged. 1 by B into B is equal to 1. So that means any rational number, the reciprocal of that rational number, it's equal to, the value is 1. So 1 is, already we know, 1 is the multiplicative identity. So let's take B is equal to 17 by 27. So what is 1 by B value? That means you want to take reciprocal. So 27 by 17. So substitute and check whether you are getting 1. So B into 1 by B is 17 by 27 multiply 27 by 17. So both numerator and denominator, if it is same number means we can cancel. So the value is 1. Then 1 by B into B is, 1 by B value is 27 by 17 and B is 17 by 27. So same value means we can cancel. It's equal to 1. So B into 1 by B is equal to 1 by B into B is equal to 1. So the multiplicative inverse property is true. Therefore, B into 1 by B is equal to 1 by B into B is equal to 1. So it's true. So already we know 1 is called the multiplicative identity.